Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by the Chief Medical Officer of Faron Pharmaceuticals, Marie-Louise Fjällskog. Marie-Louise, it's fantastic to have you back, and it's been nearly 4 months since you last spoke to us. So perhaps you'd like to give us a bit of an update about what's been going on with your lead product, Bexmarilimab.
So thank you very much for inviting me to share some updated information regarding Bexmarilimab. So I'll start with our single agent study, MATIN, in solid tumors. So this is a phase 1-2 study where we treated patients with single agent Bexmarilimab, and all of these patients were heavily pretreated. We saw very nice safety in more than 200 patients, and we also saw efficacy with disease control in up to 36% of the patients, which translated over into an overall survival benefit. So the news here is that we have put together a briefing book. So we have planned a meeting with FDA to occur in Q1 2023, where we're going to discuss the recommended phase 2 dose for further development and also potential clinical development further with Bex as a single agent. Then we have some very interesting news on our combination study, because after seeing the interesting results from the single agent, we wanted to go into combinations, of course. So we have a study called Bexmap. So this is a phase 1-2 dose escalation study where we are adding Bex to standard of care, azacitidine or azacitidine plus venetoclax in patients with myeloid malignancy. With myeloid malignancies, I mean those that are including where the cancer cell is actually the myeloid cell. So this is acute myeloid leukemia and myelodysplastic syndrome. So what is very interesting with the blood cancers is that here we have, you know, Bex is targeting cells that express CLEVER-1. And in those hematological malignancies, blood cancers, we have this CLEVER-1 expression on the actual cancer cell. So this is very interesting. We're targeting the immune cells with CLEVER-1, but also the cancer cells with CLEVER-1. So we have the results from the first cohort in the dose escalation in the doublet, where we're treating patients with refractory blood cancers, AML, MDS, but also frontline MDS. So the first 5 patients that received the first dose, 1 mg/kg every 1 week of Bex together with azacitidine, 3 out of these patients responded. So we have 3 objective responders out of 5 patients. And this is in the very first dosing cohort. So this is excellent news. And 2 of those patients that had a response, they had azacitidine, the standard of care, before going into our study. So we know that the likelihood of them responding to only azacitidine would be very low. So it's almost clinical proof of concept that adding Bex gives those objective responses. So we're super happy about that. We have presented some data at an investigator meeting at ASH last year. So ASH is the biggest conference for blood cancers. So we have a very nice collaboration with LLS, the Leukemia Lymphoma Society, and we're actually part of their accelerated program, the TAP program. So we have a good collaboration to be able to go out with this drug to as many blood cancer patients as possible. I'll end there and see if you have some questions for me.
Well, the one question I'm most interested to get the answer to is, which of all this are you personally most excited about?
I am very, very excited about having 3 objective responses in on fun patients in the first dosing cohort. So I'm looking forward to a year filled with good data for the patients. So that's very exciting.
Great stuff. So what about the rest of 2023 then, Mary Louise? What is it that you're going to be focusing on yourself in your role as Chief Medical Officer?
Well, we have the meeting with FDA, Q1 2023, which I think is going to be very interesting, where we can talk about the future of single agent Bexmarilimab. But also we will be getting data from the Bexmap study every 3 to 4 months, because that's how long it approximately takes to enroll patients into 1 dosing cohort. If we're super, super happy, we may be able to open the phase 2 part of the study, but that is too early to say.
All right. Well, we'll watch this space, Mary Louise, and hopefully we'll get an update from you before too long. But until then, thank you very much for talking to us at Proactive today.
Thank you so much. My pleasure.